During daylight, drivers have many cues to help them see where they are going. At night, they only see the few cues within the range of their headlights unless roadway lighting or retroreflective traffic control devices are present. Retroreflectivity is what makes traffic control devices, such as pavement markings, direct light from headlamps back towards the vehicle, allowing drivers to see further down the road at night. This property of pavement markings degrades over time. That's why markings need to be replaced periodically, and there are now provisions in the Manual on Uniform Traffic Control Devices, or MUTCD, to use a method to maintain minimum levels of retroreflectivity. This video was created to help you become familiar with how to comply with the pavement marking retroreflectivity provisions, now in Part 3 of the MUTCD. If you haven't already read this section, it can be found at the link in the video description. It is suggested you read that before continuing with this video. The continued use of a method designed to maintain pavement markings at or above the specific minimum retroreflectivity levels is the key factor indicating compliance with this section of the MUTCD. The choice of method or combination of methods is an important decision. You will need to decide which markings to include in your maintenance method. Also, when and how to implement, including what resources will be needed for initial and continued use of the method. Let's briefly discuss what you are trying to achieve with the maintenance method. The MUTCD standard requires your method to be designed to maintain pavement marking retroreflectivity at or above 50 on roadways with speed limits of 35 miles per hour or greater. The guidance recommends your method also maintain a higher minimum level of 100 on roadways with speed limits of 70 miles per hour or greater. These retroreflectivity levels are measured under dry conditions at 30 meter geometry and have units of millicandelas per meter squared per lux. The MUTCD recommends use of one or more of five methods covered in the FHWA publication titled Methods for Maintaining Pavement Marking Retroreflectivity. Each method is tied to minimum levels and has various needs for personnel, equipment, information, and data collection. A link to the publications is provided in the video description below. Agencies will use their selected method to identify which pavement markings are approaching minimum retroreflectivity levels and establish a plan or schedule to replace those markings before they reach minimum levels. The measured retroreflectivity method can be performed using either a handheld or mobile measurement device. It is important for personnel to be trained to calibrate and use these devices. This method directly compares the measured values of markings to the appropriate minimum levels to determine when they should be scheduled for replacement. There are two visual nighttime inspection methods, consistent parameters and calibrated pavement markings. These methods have several common features, including evaluating the markings at least 30 minutes after sunset under low beam illumination while traveling at or near the speed limit. For both visual methods, the inspector's ratings are used to determine which markings need to be scheduled for replacement. There are unique aspects to each of the visual methods. The consistent parameters method relies on the judgment of a trained inspector who is at least 60 years old to evaluate the markings. The inspector determines how well the markings meet his or her nighttime driving needs. This method ties to the minimum retroreflectivity levels because the research to establish these levels is based on the visibility needs of older drivers. A sedan is a preferred inspection vehicle because it most closely matches the research parameters. The calibrated pavement markings method uses a trained inspector of any age. Inspectors first calibrate their eyes by viewing pavement markings that have retroreflectivity values at or above the minimum levels. The calibration markings are viewed from the inspection vehicle under conditions similar to the night's inspection. The inspector then uses the visual appearance of the calibration markings to establish evaluation thresholds for that night's inspection activities. There are also two methods based on service life of pavement markings. In the historic data method, the agency documents pavement marking installation dates and other data to track the location and type of markings installed. Then, using historical data or research results for the marking parameters and degradation conditions, the agency develops a schedule to replace markings. The schedule is set to prevent the pavement marking retroreflectivity from falling below the minimum level. For the service life based on monitored markings method, an agency documents installation dates and site conditions, and then monitors the retroreflectivity of a representative sample of the markings to track durability. These monitored markings represent a larger group of similar markings in similar conditions, such as color, type, and traffic. It's important that the monitored markings be on active roadways where they will have similar traffic to the larger group they represent. When the monitored markings approach the minimum levels, the entire group of markings, both monitored and the large group they represent, are replaced. An effective approach for your agency may be to combine one or more of these methods. One example of a combined method is performing one of the visual nighttime inspection methods, followed by the measurement method for markings that do not clearly pass or fail the visual inspection. As with all the methods, the goal is to replace markings before they reach the minimum levels. Once you have selected a method, you can determine which roadways and pavement markings to include in the method. As previously mentioned, the maintenance method is required on roadways with speed limits of 35 miles per hour or greater. On roadways with speed limits of 70 miles per hour or greater, it is recommended the method provide for a longer viewing distance by using a higher minimum retroreflectivity level. Having an inventory of all roadways under your jurisdiction will be helpful for determining the extent of your system that will be covered by your method. You need to determine which roadways and which markings on those roadways to include in your maintenance method. The standard applies to longitudinal markings like center lines, edge lines, and lane lines. There are many other types of markings in use that are important, but agencies have the flexibility to decide whether or not to include these non-longitudinal markings in their method. Both the standard and guidance statements in the MUTCD reference paragraph 5 as an exception. Paragraph 5 establishes an option for longitudinal markings that may be excluded from the provisions in the standard and guidance statements. Knowing which sections of the roadway are illuminated and what the traffic volumes are on your roadways will help you determine if you want to limit your method to certain roadways. On those roadways included in your method, you also have the flexibility whether to include dotted extension lines, curb markings, parking space markings, and shared use path markings. Once you've decided on your method and which pavement markings to include, you can finalize your method by determining when and how to start implementing. The MUTCD includes a compliance date to implement and continue to use your method. How you implement your pavement marking retroreflectivity maintenance method is flexible. Here are some things you might consider. What resources are needed for inspections or monitoring? What processes will be used to translate inspection results to a replacement schedule? What weather conditions in your area limit replacing markings? Where are you planning resurfacing in the near future? How often will you reconsider which roadways and markings to include in your method? How often will you review your method and its ability to maintain markings at or above the required level? Do you want to develop a system to track pavement marking performance? You can find more information about the maintenance methods, pavement marking retroreflectivity, and nighttime visibility at the links posted below this video, or at the FHWA Nighttime Visibility website, www.fhwa.dot.gov/retro.